Hi, nice to be here. I'm going to talk about a puzzle, a monthly puzzle that I'm authoring for over a decade. It started before me many years ago when IBM had a booklet. I have it here if you want to see, with a lot of ideas what to do when you're stuck in your research, like call your mom or get a hot shower. Maybe you won't get unstuck, but at least you will be clean. And one of the hints were ponder this. And from this day on, every month we have a challenge. And can switch back to the deck. I chose several talks in this G4G and gave a sample challenge for each one of them. The first one, I heard Gwen's talk about bidding. So the challenge is about minimal perfect hash, but for those of you who are more artistic than mathematician, one of the answers I got is actually a bidded solution. It's 80 times 14 with three different colors. So you can use that. And for the mathematician in the crowd, there is still an open question regarding this minimal perfect hash. We heard a nice talk about cyclic numbers. A few years ago, I used cyclic numbers in one of my challenges. The first line, definition of a number is interesting if the product of every eight decimal digits after the decimal point is exactly 8 factorial, is actually a convoluted way of saying that it should be a cyclic number with the numbers 1 to 8. Last G4G that I attended was G4G 10, and I saw this nice game. I didn't know who it was. I used it as a riddle, but now I can give the right credit for the author. Thank you. And again, for more bigger samples, there's still an open question there. We saw a lot of nice shapes. October 2012, I asked, how can you implement all the 7 Dungeons and Dragons cubes inside a single cube? And it can be solved using a 120-face cube. I wouldn't try to say the name. Gabriel gave a little child, gave a nice talk about the juggler sequence. If he's here, I have another question that might interest him. The 2048 game, it's a game that is very hard to analyze. It's still an open question, but I asked a very simple one. And the picture here is a graph very similar to the graph that Gabriel did on the juggler sequence. Stephen Wolfram gave a very nice talk about Mathematica, but I have to accuse him of ruining one of my riddles. I asked, what is the last 10 digits of 2 to the power of 3 to the power of 4, etc. And instead of doing some nice mathematics, people just throw it into Mathematica. And the bad thing is actually the default setting of Mathematica is get the last 10 digits. I could have asked for 11 now. Alex Belos gave a nice review about Japanese puzzles. I had several on Sudoku and two about Kakuro. You can solve Kakuro uniquely. The question is, can you solve it uniquely such that any definition that you remove will make it non-uniquely solvable? Of course, it can't be done because the sum of the horizontal and the vertical is the same, so you have to remove two definitions. And the question is, can you build a Kakuro that has only one solution, but if you remove any two definition, it becomes non-uniquely solvable? That's easy. So the months after that, I asked, can you do it when removing any two definition makes any square undetermined? And you can do that. All the questions are and the solutions are in the on the site. I saw Theodore's mechanical toys. And this reminded me about a question I asked about efficient gearing. I used for the question, can you find two sets of numbers that multiplying one from each set gives you all the numbers up to some small perturbation? And one of the answers I got is, the problem is dumb. I hope you build computer better than bicycles because the gears are divided, not multiplied. I know that, but it's, the riddle is much nicer when you multiply instead of division. So it's not a bike, it's something else. I heard a research about a cat falling from towers. Somebody took 30,000 cats. He was a veterinarian and he got these cats after they fell, and he realized that there are some a cat that falls between the sixth floor and the 32nd floor is much more vulnerable than cats that fall behind the outside this part. So I made a challenge about that, a challenge about Golomb pentominoes, Colonel Belluto game. It's non-transitive for multiple players. This is the 11A is the 13 talk. I don't have time, but there is a nice come ask me later about privacy. And the last slide is the current open challenge, April. You're invited to try it. And this is a picture of one of the solvers. If there are any other solvers in the crowd who would like to take a selfie, thank you. Oh, and of course, in Hebrew, the word love, ahava, the gematria of it is 13. Thank you.